Good evening, everybody, and welcome once again to our channel of Nifty 50 Running. And as always, thank you very much for your support, your questions, comments, and subscriptions. As always, much appreciated. Now, it's Saturday evening, the 22nd of May, and the reason I'm telling you that is because in the morning, I shall be taking part in my first race since October of last year. And tomorrow's race will be the Heaton Park Half Marathon. I've not really trained for it, to be honest. I've done a few long runs, etc., but I've not done much speed work and I've not really prepped for this race. It's just been, not a last minute decision, but something I decided not very long ago, and I thought I'll give it a go. It'd be nice to get out there, you know, and meet some fellow runners and see what it feels like to be out in a crowd running together again. And hopefully it'll give me a bit more motivation to push myself somewhat further. But what I wanted to do tonight was just a quick run through of what I will be taking with me. And these are as follows, which I've laid out. Now, I don't know what the weather's going to be. So I've got two pairs of shoes, which are the Boston 9s and the Adidas Ultra Boost 20s. So I'm undecided what to wear. I'd say it depends on the weather. And what I shall be taking with me, I've got my vest, because I'm going to need to take everything with me, because I want to film some of it as well. So it's important. I've got plenty of pockets for everything. I've got a towel in case it's wet when I finish. Sunglasses in case it's hot or sunny or anything, you never know. And gloves in case it's cold. I've got some Vaseline, again, if it's wet, rub all over my toes, etc. A couple of painkillers and some gel, pain relief gel, because I'm not getting younger and the old bones are beginning to suffer a little bit. I've got a drink, cab drink, and Jelly Babies. I won't take them all, they're just in case emergency. If I'm a bit hungry when I get there, I've got banana, and I've got a couple of gels. One I'll have at the start, one halfway. Spare pair of socks, again, because of the rain. And finally, my hat in case it's raining, and my bag to put everything in. So that's everything. It seems a lot. I'm not running a marathon, but you've got to be prepared for every eventuality. So what I'm going to do, my kit's already laid upstairs. I shall get what I don't need straight away in the bag, all packed up ready in the morning, and I shall speak to you in the morning when I'm all ready to go. Right, good morning everybody. Today is race day, yay. How am I feeling? A little bit nervous, apprehensive. It's been a while, but I'm sure I'll be fine. I've no sort of aims, goals. Had a really easy week, not done much mileage, legs feeling good, and I haven't really got a time in mind. I'm just gonna run, see how I feel, not push too hard. If I feel good, I might do, but just enjoy it really and just get a feeling of being back out there with other runners. Just about to have my breakfast. I'll be having porridge and banana and a nice cup of tea and with a bit of treacle in, which is normally my standard for a race. So right, I'll have that, get organised, and we shall set off in, I don't know, half an hour, 40 minutes. Okay. Right then, I'm in the car. It is time to put the sat nav on and set off. Here in Leeds, it's cool, but it's very cool. It's cloudy, but there's very little wind, just a light breeze. So hopefully everything should be okay. So we'll get the sat nav on and hopefully we can get organized and get going, and we will see you. I'll see you when I get there. So I've arrived at my destination. Didn't take too long. It's still only 5 to 8, and the race doesn't start till 9:30, but it looks like people are arriving already in a big car park in the middle of the park. But you apparently to pay for parking, but it's not too bad. I think it's £3 for over 3 hours, which in general terms is pretty good. So I'm going to go pay for my parking, get back in the car, and have a banana, I think, chill for a bit, have a drink, and that's it for the moment. Right, let's go have a little explore. It's a dead event village this way, so we'll have a walk down. That's it, it's still pretty early. It's a bit chilly. Wind seems to have picked up, but no rain or anything. It's just quite pleasant, good running conditions. No idea what the course looks like, but we'll have a walk down and see what's going on. Right guys, we're down at the event village, as you can see. I've gone down and collected a number, and I've gone over there and got a nice hot coffee, because it's actually a really cold wind blowing. And it's not exactly flat either, so it could be an interesting race. So I'm going to walk back to the cow, this big hill, that could be part of the course, and get warm for 10 minutes drinking coffee. Right, so I'm back in the relative warmth of the car, because it is quite chilly out there, and so that wind seems to have picked up. And this is my race number, 1810. I can't really make out of that. Sometimes I try and make a time out of it, but I don't think it's possible with this one. Today's time, I don't know, anything under 140, I'll be happy with that. 135, I'm really chuffed. Anything on from that, wow, well, that'd be really, really good. Like I say, I've not been training sort of specifically for a race, just running and getting some miles in. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to finish my coffee, get warm, chill for a bit, and then I'll get my number on, get my gear organised, and back down to the start and do a jog around and a warm up. Right, that's me all organised and ready. I've only got one more job to do, and that is the toilet. It's pretty cold. The breeze down at the bottom, so I'm keeping sheltered here, and everyone's doing the warm-ups, etc. And that's what I'm going to do too. I'm going to have a little walk, a little stretch, a little run round, see how I feel, and crack on. Alright everyone, it's about 20 minutes to go. Done my stretching, leg swings, everything. If you looked at Jonathan's last video, you'll see all that. Followed it pretty closely and it's brilliant. Gonna have a quick warm up now. Jog around for 10 minutes. No idea where I'm going, but I'm not gonna go far away from the village. As far as race concerns and filming, I'll have to see how I feel. I feel good, or I'm just not making much effort. I'll try and film as I go around. If not, well, it might be near the end, but I'll try and do a little bit just before we start when we're all lining up. See how it goes. Feeling good. Legs feel fine. No injuries, no aches and pains. I feel good. So I'm going to enjoy it. Right guys, we've been called now to our starting zones. I'm in pink, which is, I don't know, about third one down. And we're going to have a PT warm-up, but I don't have to be doing that, so I've done a bit already. So let's head round to the start, and I'll try and film as and when I can, but it might be difficult depending on how I'm feeling.
I think I made a bit of a crack up there. I seem to be way, way downfield in my starting rate. Hundreds of companies. Yeah, I've heard people talking about 2 hours. 2 hours at this one, so yeah. Definitely I'm in the wrong bit.
It's going to be mental, you get to the start map.
Time we'll say how we're
doing. 2 cues,
please. Just about to approach the start point. I've got to stay between the cones, so it's all over to Kyle, etc. And yeah, we're just coming up to the line at the start now.
Up the Didsbury runners.
So
keeping it nice and steady and keeping that walk until we get you over the line.
Right guys, so a couple miles in. Of course, I'd say he's undulating. Lots of twists and turns. I'm just going to get steady, enjoying it. So far, so good.
Right guys, so we're right halfway through. It's tough. Some steep hills, proper wind, and 5k and 10k driving. So yeah. And there's a lot of swerving them out. 5k and 10k runners in. So I'm just taking it really steady. There's what we've done on our 48 minutes so far. Very slow for me, but I'm enjoying it. Alright guys, we're over 10 miles now. Only 5k to go. One lap, it's like a 4-lap course. One steep hill against wind, which is tough. But I'm well in it now, so hope we've got an ambulance approaching. Still over 3 miles to go.
and yeah, not too bad. Very unfit, but I can make it. Right guys, running to the finish line now. Not another mile to go. Legs are tired. That wind really took it out. Yeah, those hills are really steep, but we're on the last little section now. I can't wait to finish, to be honest. I'm getting really tired. But it's a good test to that's how my fitness is. And yeah, I want to run 3 hours at London. We have to put a lot more effort in. But here we go. Got to finish line. I said about 1:40. And that's what I'm going to do.
Running gear, loungewear as well, some of the best on the market.
Right, that's me done. Well, fitness wise, I have a lot of work to do. But then again, it was very windy and there was one with a steep hill. That was pretty tough. It was against the wind a lot of it. So yeah, I mean, I don't know what the overall elevation was of the race, so when I download it onto Strava, I'll check that out. So I'm going to have me drink of water, my protein bar and my flapjack, and then going to have a walk back to the car, get warmed up and head home. So I'll do a bit of a longer review a bit later on, but just get a bit of my breath back now. Just a quick one, I'm back in the car now, all done, warmed up, had a drink, back to eat, and it started to rain, so that was perfect timing. So I'm going to head on now and then reflect on the race as I'm driving, it'll pass the time, and then once I'm home, organised, etc, I'll give like a full reflection on it. But I did it, didn't stop, it was tough. But yeah, I'm glad I came over and made the effort, and yeah, I'll give more details when I get back in, I don't know, 40 minutes or so. Right everyone, that's me back home, safe and sound. Just a quick recap now on the race. Positives were that I went over there, I took part in the race, I ran it all, didn't stop. And yeah, it was just nice to be running with other people, you know, a bit of an atmosphere, you know, everybody's was all chatty and cheery, and yeah, it was really good in that respect. As far as the negatives are, it's probably my slowest half marathon I've done since the first one I ever did, like in 2017, I think it was. So in that respect, I need to change my training, start doing a bit more speed work, make more of an effort, and see how it goes. I'm going to do another race probably middle of June. So it gives me a few weeks of training and pushing myself a bit harder and see how that goes. I'm not sure what my chip time was. I think on my watch is about 1:39. So yeah, it's not particularly good for me, and my PB's about 1:26, but that was done nearly 2 years ago, and a lot of things have happened since then. Maybe I'm expecting too much of myself. I'll be 56, yep, in a couple of months. So maybe I'm not going to get any faster, but who knows? I'm going to make the effort anyway and see what happens. So I hope you've enjoyed this insight into the race, and I know a lot of you will be racing again at the moment, which is fab for everybody. But I hope you've enjoyed it, and if so, just like it, subscribe it, comment with any questions at all, and I'll be happy to answer them, and there'll be a lot more to come for us. One thing I have noticed, that definitely need a GoPro. It was difficult trying to take my phone out of my pocket, couldn't run one of it in my hand and try to film. It wasn't easy, so technology wise I need to improve, but you know, it was nice filming for everybody, and I don't feel I really pushed myself too much. Took it really steady up the hills. There was one steep hill and it was in the wind. And because I think we did 4 laps of little course, 3 and a bit miles. Yeah, 4 times up that hill. It was pretty tough. I haven't put it down on Strava yet, and I don't know what position I came in. I don't really care, to be honest. I was just glad to get out there and finish and earn my medal. And yeah, I'm happy with that. So more work to come. We'll probably do some videos on the next stage of training. And hopefully by the time the next race, things will be looking a bit brighter. So thanks as always for tuning in and watching and subscribing, you know, etc. It's brilliant that, you know, so many people are supporting us, and Jonathan will be putting some more on. He's the expert.
I just follow what he tells me basically, and no doubt he'll tell me now this is what you need to do, and I will listen like everybody else should really. So yeah, thanks very much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Bye for now, and remember, you're never too old.